Hey, it's Cassie here with Super Sister Fitness. I'm a women's health and weight loss expert from Cassie.net. And today we are talking about the three keys to boosting your metabolism. Make sure you listen through the end so you don't miss any of these three keys, and comment, like, and subscribe to hear more food and fitness tips. All right, let's dive into talking about all things metabolism. So real quick, what's a metabolism and why does it matter? So your metabolism is how efficiently your body is burning through the things that you're eating and drinking. And when your metabolism is boosted, it's easier to burn fat, you have more energy, you feel more focused and more alive and more vibrant. You just feel more like yourself and even more like the Energizer Bunny during the day. Versus when your metabolism is bogged down, you feel lethargic, kind of groggy, maybe kind of cranky. It's really, really hard to lose weight if you have weight to lose. And just overall, you just don't feel ready to tackle the world. So that's why these three keys are really, really important. And these are things that we're not hearing a lot about. So let's dive right in. All right, number one, eat more fat. Now let me clarify, we wanna make sure we're eating the right types of fat, but this one is really important because as women, especially if you've done any dieting over the years, like so many of us have, we're so used to eating low fat and fat free that hearing, you know, something like eating more fat can actually be kind of scary. And oftentimes there's a lot of unbrainwashing that we need to do. So first and foremost, I want you to realize that fat is really important for your metabolism, and eating fat to burn fat can seem kind of backwards, but it's actually really important as long as it's the right types of fat. So when I'm talking about the right types of fat, I'm talking about coconut oil, olives, nuts, seeds, even butter if you don't have a sensitivity. These types of fats will actually help you to burn more fat. And the reason is that fat actually helps your body to assimilate and absorb carbohydrates and the sugar that carbohydrates turn into when you eat them. And I won't go all sciencey on you right now, but just so you know, when you eat fat, it helps you burn fat because it's helping to keep your blood sugar levels stable during the day. And what happens when your blood sugar levels are stable is your pancreas secretes your fat burning hormone called glucagon, and glucagon actually burns fat for energy. So that's why when you eat more fat, when it's the right types, your body can actually burn fat. Plus, you feel energetic and focused during the day. Your brain is made up of over 70% fat. So when you're eating the right types of fat, you can just think more clearly. So tip number one, eat more fat and the right types of fat: coconut oil, butter, olive oil, avocado, nuts, and seeds, lots of these fats. Now, I usually recommend a couple tablespoons just to start, especially if you're someone who hasn't really been eating a lot of fat and you're kind of nervous. Just notice how every time you eat, if you have just a couple tablespoons, notice that boost in your moods, that boost in your energy levels, and it should be consistent throughout the day. So you'll notice that you not only feel better after you eat and more satisfied, but you feel better and more energetic and more confident and more stable throughout the day. So number one, eat more fat. And just a quick note about saturated fats, because you might be hearing me mention fats like coconut oil and butter and be like, whoa, I thought those were bad for you. And I actually wrote an extensive article about why saturated fats like coconut oil and butter are actually really good for you. So we're linking that below. Go ahead and check that out if you want to learn more. All right, number two is eat more protein, especially for women. We see so many of our female clients that just aren't eating a lot of protein. And protein is really important when it comes to boosting your metabolism. Protein can actually increase your metabolism up to 35% for the following 2 to 3 hours after you eat it. And I say that because it's important to eat protein throughout the day. So a lot of times when we think about protein, we think about, you know, a little bit of chicken on our salad at lunch and maybe, you know, a little bit of protein or meat at dinner, but that's oftentimes the only time we're eating protein. So I want you to be thinking about having protein every single time you eat. And it doesn't need to be a lot, but maybe like just a couple ounces. So your hand, the thickness and the circumference of the palm of your hand, that's a really good portion size for protein to shoot for. So that might be a couple eggs, maybe hard-boiled eggs at snack time. It might be, you know, having chicken on your salad at lunch, but you wanna make sure you're getting enough. Oftentimes when you're ordering a salad at a restaurant, they're kind of skimpy with the protein. So a lot of times it's good to ask for more, even like an extra serving on the side. And this goes with tip number one, you want to eat more fat and more protein because both of these will actually keep you satisfied and boost your metabolism. So I actually like to think PFC. So every time I eat, I'm like, where's my protein? Where's my fat? And where are my carbohydrates? And you might notice that it's really easy to get in carbohydrates, and that's totally fine to get in carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are important, but we also wanna make sure that we're balancing them out with protein and fat. for our metabolism. And this is actually what helps keep our blood sugar levels stable. So I mentioned with the fat tip that you wanna make sure you're eating to keep your blood sugar levels stable so you can burn fat for energy. And that's what makes us feel the most energetic. And that's what keeps our mood stable and keep our energy levels up. And it helps us to burn fat. So think about protein, fat, and carbs, PFC. Now, as far as types of protein, the best kinds for your metabolism are going to be your animal protein. So meat, fish, eggs, there are definitely some good protein powders and other options. But a lot of times when we start to look at foods like beans as protein, we notice that beans actually have 3 times the amount of carbohydrates as they do protein. So it's totally fine to eat beans, but when we're looking at the PFC scale, I always count those as a carbohydrate and try to get in an extra protein source. So number 2, eat more protein to boost your metabolism. When it comes to quality with protein, this is really important, especially for women, because having meat that's injected with hormones, which is oftentimes what they do, can interfere with our own hormonal balance. So you want to be looking for high quality protein sources. Terms that you're looking for are free range, organic, grass-fed, pasture-raised, and just do the best that you can. You don't have to be perfect, but strive to have high quality protein sources. And tip number 3 for boosting your metabolism is to exercise less. Now, let me explain this, because I'm a huge proponent of exercise, especially here at Super Sister Fitness. And the thing with exercise is that we just don't want to be overdoing it. So the best types of exercise for your metabolism are the ones that are shorter, but they're high intensity. So terms like Tabata, HIIT training, like more of the CrossFit style workouts, these are gonna be really, really good for your metabolism compared to the longer like hamster wheel workouts, like running marathons or doing the elliptical for like an hour or two at a time. These are actually the kind that can drain your metabolism because they can cause a buildup of inflammation in your body. So you actually wanna be doing the ones that boost your metabolism and give you the most energy. And these are the kinds that are a little bit shorter, but more intense. Another type of exercise to boost your metabolism the most is strength training. A lot of times we don't think about this because we think of the cardio as more of what boosts your metabolism, but with strength training, it helps to build muscle, and the more muscle you have, the more boosted your metabolism is going to be. So I recommend alternating, you know, strength training, doing that 3 to 4 times a week, and then working in those Tabata style, the high intensity interval training workouts a couple times a week as well. And overall, just having an active lifestyle, moving throughout the day. So, you know, setting an alarm on your phone every hour, getting up and stretching and moving. This is really good for your metabolism too. It's not just the, you know, time that you're spending at the gym. It's also the active lifestyle that keeps your metabolism boosted. All right, so to quick recap, the 3 keys to boosting metabolism are eating more fat, eat more protein, and exercise less, but do the right types of exercise. Again, I'm Cassie, health and weight loss expert from cassie.net. That's linked below if you wanna find out more how I can support you in your journey. Go ahead and check that out. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more health and fitness tips, and I will see you next time.